Hello, today I want to do a video on five of my favorite concealed carry guns. But let me define concealed carry. Concealed carry, to me, doesn't mean the teeniest, smallest gun that you can carry conveniently. It means the gun you think you will need on a particular day that you can conceal and other people can't see it from the outside. So that gives you a wide scope, and my guns are a wide scope. Just like golf clubs, you have a different one for every hole, same thing. So instead of going down some list or something, I'm going to grab one at a time, explain what I mean by this particular handgun. They're not top to worst. These are all what I think are good concealed carry guns and why I think such. I was a cop for 25 years and I used to carry guns all the time. And off duty, because when you're a cop working in a big city, it's a serious thing that you want to be prepared, because people who probably didn't appreciate your free holiday at Hotel Sing Sing, if they see you, could cause an issue. So that's why off-duty cops carry guns. And I think today people should carry guns that are legally and lawfully can do so and psychologically able to handle the stress and the safety issues of carrying a gun. And aren't doing an unlawful act because by law they're not permitted to have one. And as far as I'm telling you, five of my favorites, any gun that you can carry to help you stay safe will help you out. That's fine. You might carry 22, 25, 45, that's up to you. But I'm going to show you five that I like to carry. But carrying any gun, if you actually carry it, is better than carrying nothing. You'll hear a lot of different things. People take it off you if you're a woman and kill you with it. They're going to kill you, they're going to kill you with it or without it, so you might as well put a few holes in. Because when their blood pressure drops, they're going to be running for the emergency room. So, it's good to carry if you can. We'll always protect you now. If you're not trained real well or you don't have good awareness to give you enough time to get your gun in the ready position, you know, the best trained, best shooter, the gun may not save them. You have to be able to fight as well. So you have to be an overall package if you're a cop, because when a cop, you go to the crime. Crime's going down here, you're a cop. Crime's going down here, you're a civilian, you should be doing this. That's what you should be doing. Unless somebody's getting hurt, and morally you think you should do something about it, then you have to take action, take appropriate steps, announce, let everybody know that you're a good guy, and tell the bad guy to cease and desist. And you're there only for the bad guy. Make sure people know that. If the cops come, put your gun down. Have witnesses tell them you're trying to help. But most of the time, citizens this way, cops that way. So sometimes gun choices are based on those separate type of experiences. So let me go get the first gun. Cut right here. No sense wasting the tape. Okay, the first gun I'm going to show you is a 380. This is my wife's 380, but I like it a lot, and there are probably some wives looking for a good gun. This is a SIG 290, and it's a beautiful, it's a 290 RS specifically, and it's a really, really nice 380. Very reliable, has a good trigger, has good night sights. Downloaded and safe, you saw me drop the hammer. And it shoots excellent. It has never had a hiccup. Knock on wood. It's an excellent choice, the SIG 290 RS. It's easy to pull the slide back. For some men or women with arthritis or don't have enough strength, that's a good thing to have. Easy to pull back. The trigger is really smooth. Easy to pull back. The sights are great. And it's a really, really good shooter. It's a SIG 290. Now, a lot of people question the 380, whether it's an effective gun. Like I said, any gun to put holes in people, if that's all you can carry, that's fine. But a 380 with today's ammo, like the Lehigh, they have these ultimate defense loads. They use cavitation like a torpedo. If you look them up, they explain the technical parts to you. But it makes the 380 more effective than the old 38s and some 9mm. Penetration and the actual physical damage the causes and the target to make people slow down and takes them out of the fight. So this is the SIG 290RS. I can think of nothing bad about this. And I have a Glock 43, which is a 9mm, which is a slightly bigger than this, if you can handle a 9, which you'll see shortly. But if you want compact with enough power to put a decent bullet through it, 380 like this is good because it's effective. A little more costly than some of the cheaper 380s, but it's very reliable. That's the main thing. As a cop, the main thing for us, when you go like this, the guy goes boom. We don't care if it's $10 pistol or $10,000 custom gun. If it doesn't go boom, I don't need it. Oh, cut right here. Start over. This is the Glock 43 I was just telling you about. Not much bigger at all than the 380. It's a full 9mm. Now, being a Glock, this one matches its reputation of being reliable, excellent shooter, great gun. Both of these guns are single stacks, depending on what magazines. You can carry all the way from 6 up to 9 between these last two guns. And I have one for this one, it's 12. It extends from the bottom. ETS, it's clear, translucent magazine. Now this thing is really, really good. I shoot this out to 100 yards all day long on a human silhouette B27 police qualification target. I don't shoot bullseye targets. I shoot human shaped targets because that's who is going to be attacking me. This is the defensive gun, it's not a bullseye gun. So I want to know where center mass is. People don't have bullseyes on them. So it's a good practice to use the silhouette targets. From my point of view, I've been doing it for a long time. And the 43 is a little harder. It's substantially harder to pull back the slide than this SIG 380, which is one of the reasons it's nice for older people or people who don't really want to pull back on a hard slide. They could have hand injuries, whatever the reason is. It's a striker trigger, a little shorter. It's a decent trigger. My favorite trigger, I'll show you later, another gun, but the shoot's good. And this is the Talo version. I have a night sight that glows in the dark up front, not in the back. If you get night sights and they're all the same color, it can be confusing in the dark. You whip up and see through three dots. That's why I like the single one up front for up close self-defense. But it's a super, super gun, the Glock 43. I have nothing bad to say about this. Thing shoots all day long, from 100 yards on in, left-handed, right-handed, hip shooting, point shooting, whatever you want to do with this little Glock, this will do it. And like I say, you can get up to a 12-round magazine for it. You have the full power of 9mm. Those ammo I was telling you about, the Lehigh bullets, come in 9mm, 45, 380, even 32. So, that's the story of the Glock. Okay, I said I was going to tell you my favorite 5 guns, make it 6. I went and grabbed my wife's 32. She carries a 380, she carries a 32. A Beretta, which is a tip-up barrel. The reason I remember that, because I was telling you about sometimes it's hard to pull a slide back. Well, if you're that kind of person, let me get this bullet here. And if you're that kind of person that has a problem with the tip-up barrel, you can put the bullet in there and shut it and just put the magazine in the gun. And you're ready to go. And just shut it and it's ready to shoot, no magazine in it. It's a 32 Tomcat Beretta. Now a 32 is rolling the small side, but with these new bullets I was telling you about, these Super Defense from Lehigh, I'll take a picture of it and put it in the video because it's so small, you're not going to see it right now. For this one, and there's different styles. The 32 is different than all the rest, the 9mm or 45. But I'll take a picture of it next to this gun. But this will make this thing penetrate and be effective, trust me. It's smaller and lighter than the other two guns you saw. And it's a pop-up barrel, which really helps people who have weak hands. All you have to do is put the bullet in. Most of the time, the guns, you have to slide it. Pull it back and rack it. This one, you pop it up, one in the tube, and you can shoot that if that's all you had in the tube. Didn't even have a magazine, you can shoot that. Oh, this one has a built-in safety. I forgot about that. Oh, there it goes. I had the safety on. Okay, so you can shoot that first shot even if you didn't get the magazine in. But once you put the magazine in, one of the tubes is ready to go. Whereas the other automatics, you have to put the magazine in and rack one by rack and slide. So that saves you a lot of hand strength required to operate this gun. And the 32 is on the weaker end of the scale, but I wouldn't want to be shot by one, especially with these bullets. They'll put holes through your hearts and your lungs. And your blood pressure drops again, you're not going to be thinking about fighting, you're going to be thinking about flight right to the emergency room. So, even though people say, well, that's a small gun, like I told you before we started, this 32 in your hand is better than a 45 in your glove box if somebody's right here getting ready to kill you. So, any gun that you will carry is good for me. And with good ammo, makes it even better. This new ammo really steps up these smaller guns that the cops used to carry undercover for drug work, narcs, stuff like that. Or people who dress lightly, don't wear belts, like some women may not, some men don't. So they don't want to have heavyweight. Believe me, with this ammo, you wouldn't want to be shot. If a guy really showed up, and I didn't even have my 9, I wish he had my 500 Smith & Wesson. I used to teach rookie cops, they always want the smallest, lightest gun they could get. But if somebody actually approached them and hurt them, I wish they had the big 44 Magnum. It's just the way humans are. When it's convenient, you carry it, but when it's time, the stuff goes down, you'll wish you had a machine gun. But, like I say, this is better than this. But this comes in handy too for good martial arts. If you can do that, that even makes you better. And not only does it help your shooting with your concentration, but it helps you to deflect, hold people off to try to get your gun until you can get a shot or two off. So, you shouldn't mix both, but if not, whatever gun you'll carry and can shoot, carry it. Cut, get the next gun. Next one will be... Okay, now, what I call my ultimate last ditch backup shoot gun. Things go down, I was going out to check, trash, put it out late at night or something. I threw this in my pocket. This is a double derringer. You'll love this thing. Double tap, super light, 45, just like the big 45. Just packs the punch. Empty. You got two shots, 45. Everybody says it's only two shots. Well, push came to shove, you're hiding behind cover, you got two more. Just drop them in, you're ready to go. Now, as far as the two shots go, for over a century, hunters have been hunting African elephants and lions with a two-shot double rifle. Looks like this. Two shots. This gives you two shots. From here to camera, this is flat, light, easy to carry. Somebody comes up to you, and they're going to harm you seriously or kill you. Two shots, 45 this range, will probably do you well. And then if you have to run off, get behind cover, pull out two more, just drop these in, rip them off, and you got two more. I love this little unique gun. But one thing, caveat I must say, this is for people who are more of a beast with a gun. You have to be... Let's say invincible with recoil. Because this little sucker puts out a little bit of recoil, being so light with a 45 caliber bullet. But you will never notice it if somebody from me, the camera, with a machete, looks like someone from a dangerous gang, or just some psycho or a terrorist, their ex-husband or whoever. I'm just saying, from here to there, nobody's going to want to challenge this 45. It's real easy to carry. Have nothing else but your swimsuits on. Okay, one more, then we'll have the six. Okay, now this is for us old school guys. This is called a 1911. Safe. It's 45 caliber, shoots the same thing as that derringer does. Now, a lot of people say, just like the little guns are too small, this is too big to carry concealed. Trust me. I put this in the holster on my side, and I'm wearing this shirt inside the pants, you will never see it. And I'll never notice it. I carried a gun this heavy for 25 years in the street, carrying it with all of the other stuff. You gotta remember, the average cop carries this gun, 2 to 4 extra magazines, a taser, 2 pair of handcuffs, a nightstick, or PR, mace, or what they call it, whatever you call it now, different type things. Okay, he's got a bulletproof vest on. Most of them carry a knife on their vest and a backup gun, kind of like one of these guns over here. And that's the basics. And a portable radio. So he's got all of that. When I'm off duty carrying this, it's like I'm on a lightweight vacation, okay? But for you civilians that don't aren't old school, this gun is legendary. It's single action, which means you have to pull the trigger and you have to cock it to shoot it. But once the first round goes off, it goes back, of course, and cocks it forward. That's what semi-automatic does. So once it's cocked, you're ready to go. So if you cock it and lock it, this has a lock here. It locks the hammer so it won't go forward. And it has a safety on the grip. So even if you take the safety off, it won't fire. So if you accidentally forgot to put that on there, you bump the trigger, it won't fire. You have to grip it, the grip safety, then it will fire. And the 1911's good ones like this SIG have the sweetest trigger in handguns for a carry gun. This isn't a target gun, this is a competition gun, although this could be made to a competition gun quite nicely. For on a street gun, you'll get a sweeter trigger than this, and it's fast. I used to use these as a demonstration at the police academy. I used to have it in my holster, and I'd have a rookie pointing a gun at me. Unloaded, of course. And I would draw, fire, before they could pull the holster and shoot me. Because the average person, about a quarter of a second to draw, some were a little quicker, I was drawing faster now. That's a long time ago. Lighter, faster, and quicker, and dumber. That comes in handy when you're a cop, being a little bit dumber on occasion. But these are sweet. They're nice carry pieces. It's empty and safe. So don't complain. You're putting the gun at the camera. The gun camera doesn't bleed, so don't worry about it. And I'm in a building. There's nothing on this floor other than me. So, love my 1911s. Like I told you at the beginning, carry is what you want to carry. If you can fit this, especially in the winter, you're wearing heavy coats anyway. If you live anywhere where it's cold here, you might not wear this in Miami while you're surfing. But single action 1911, this is what we call old school. A lot of young people still like them, but they work well. This gun on a human sized torso, out to 200 yards all day long with the regular sights. And it has night sights, which are nice. I haven't always had night sights. I was on duty before I had night sights. You learn to shoot without them, but they're a little bit helpful if you have the time. But up close, like where a camera is, a guy jumps you and you're pulling a gun, sometimes you don't have time to see the sights, much less that they're lit up. Because as I'm pulling that close, I'm hip shooting you. I can hip shoot oranges at that range all day long. So I'm going to shoot, boom, 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 then come up to the sights. But now, if you are aware you see somebody coming, or you're in your house, you're going to find that person, when you're watching the night sights are nice, because then you know where they are. But by surprise, you're usually not going to see them. You're going to go boom, 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 boom. But they're nice to have if you can get the option. That's my favorite six. And this one here is particularly, is very reliable. I've had a lot of 1911s. I've had some older ones in the old days, in the 70s, some Colts that had issues. 10mm Colt that had a lot of issues. But the 45s, 1911s, the last few I had a Wilson, was CQB. This one, pretty damn reliable. So that's six. I ran out of storage space in my other cameras, my backup camera. And I believe it's on black and white right now, and that's fine. But the other guns I want to show you is a Glock 19. Empty and safe. Glock 19 is a medium-sized Glock. A little bigger than the 43 Glock. a little fatter because it has a double stack magazine. It holds 15 rounds instead of 6 or 7. And again, you can get extended mags for it. It's a real sweet gun. This is the gun I carry most of the time if the possibilities are out there. Not the probabilities, but the possibilities at this stage in my life. But because it's easy to hide, but it's big enough that you can shoot, getting a full grip on it. Just yesterday I put a night sight up front, so it's matched to my 43 with a night sight up front, the Taylor model. And a striker trigger like that one, pull the trigger and shoot. Simple as that. And it's real reliable, feeds everything. It's a great gun. Now, some people think it's too big compared to the other small guns that you saw, but it's a nice all-around carry gun. Like I say, carry depends on your needs and what you need to do with it. The 19, I can highly recommend it. This thing just doesn't fail, takes a beating, and it's really, really accurate. Shoot this all day long out to 100 yards. Like I told you before, right out of the gun store, right to the range the same day, first shot's about 100 yards. Because if you're hitting the targets good at 100 yards or reasonable, you know you don't have any issues with the sights or the gun. Then you come back and shoot whatever range you consider normal. And you may have to do some small tweaking, but right off the bat, you know, that lets you know what your weaknesses are right off the bat. So it's got a longer sight radius than the 43, which means a teeny bit of errors or less on the target and how the further out you go. And it's a super, super nice gun. The Glock 19. You can't beat it. I just wanted to let them know that if somebody's pointing a gun at you, or you're pointing a gun at the bad guy, they can draw and shoot you before you pull the trigger. And that's in a lot of cases. You know, like guys that have guns that have surrender, they can go boom, have no chance. That's why people say, what is pointing the gun at the cop? That doesn't mean anything. If he has a gun, I'm telling you, 99.9% of you people watching this, if I have this gun in my hand anywhere, you move my back to you, I'm telling you, boom, I can shoot you. Before you get shot off, or at the same time, which doesn't do you any good. So when you see a cop saying, well, the gun wasn't pointed at me, he wouldn't drop it. This guy is a risk and a danger. And I'll just do it. I'll show you with dry fire. Let's try an experiment. Put your hands like this. Now when you see me point the gun at you, clap, and see if you clap before I shoot. You'll hear the click, okay? So I'm here saying, I surrender. So, you shot me and wiped my brow, didn't you? Let's do it again, okay? The whole thing is, you have to wait until you see it pointing at you. Well, that's where a prompt comes in. Boom, you're dead. Now you see it in. Guns out. Guys have a gun, it's dangerous. So, it's really, really, really bad.